In this video, I'm going to show you how to simply embed video on your website from your YouTube channel. Doing this increases time on your website, which is great for SEO. It creates more video plays on that video, which can help your video rank higher on YouTube. One of my YouTube videos on a blog post is getting 20% of the clicks on that page and doubled my dwell time of how long people were staying on that page. Very significant to do this. In 2018, people want video. So this is important that you know how to simply embed video on your blog post and on your website. So what we have here, I've got a WordPress editor. I'm going to show you a couple ways to do this. And I've got a video open here. So let's say I have a video that I posted. And by the way, you can actually embed video that you didn't make as long as whoever uploaded the video left the embed options on, you have the license and permission to embed that video on your website. That's part of YouTube's regulations. If the uploader did not want anybody to be able to embed it, they can turn that option off. But if it's on, you can do it. So all you have to do is open the video that you want to embed. And then we're going to go over here to the share option, and we're going to click share. Now, you have a couple of ways to do this. If you're using a plugin like Shortcode Ultimate, which I absolutely love, I'm going to click here and go to insert shortcode, and I'm going to click on my YouTube advanced option. And what I'm able to do here is I can embed a playlist, but I've preset how wide I want the video to be. Do I want it to be responsive? What kind of player controls I want to show up? So this makes it quick, easy for me. I have a default setting and I don't have to think about it too much. And so what I do is I take this URL, this video URL, and I just paste it right here. And I'll show you right here in the live preview what it's going to look like. And then I can just drop it in. Now, here is what it looks like with the short code, but if I click preview, you're going to be able to see what it looks like on the actual blog post. For me, this is the quickest and easiest and the optimal way to do it because I have all my presets in there, which is the way I like to do it. But if you like and you're not using that and you have a standard website WYSIWYG editor, what you can do instead is go over here to embed. And now if the uploader did not want you to embed this on your website, this would be grayed out. You wouldn't be able to access this code. Now what you can do here is you can choose your video size. What do you want the size to be? And width is going to matter on a desktop, not on a mobile. On a mobile, if your website is responsive, your video is probably going to respond and be the correct size. But on desktop, it really matters. You don't want this tiny little box on your blog post that isn't symmetric with everything else, okay? Then you can decide, do you want it to show suggested videos? I always uncheck that because I don't want my competition's video showing up in the end or some inappropriate, you know, which happens a lot on YouTube, to show up at the end and offend somebody. Now here I can show player controls. Do I want them to be able to stop, forward, and all that? Yes, I do. Do I want the video title to show up there? I don't need that, so I usually uncheck that. So I'll leave that one checked. And then it changes the code as you do that. So then what we're going to do is we're going to take this iframe code here, and we're going to put it on the text, and we're going to embed it right here. And then I'll show you the preview. And it looks the same. Now, in case you didn't see what I just did, let me show you one more time. On the short code, we're working right here on the WYSIWYG editor, on the visual editor. But if you're embedding an iframe, it's a code that needs to go in the code section. So you click text and you paste it here instead. That's the major difference. And you can paste that anywhere you want on a page. Now, people often ask me, does embedding a video help you with your SEO? Well, it does as a indirect fashion. So when you have video on the page on a blog post, which I've now made it a practice to put it on as many videos on as many as I can, It increases the dwell time, which means how long that person is staying on your page. Well, what we know is with Rank Brain and with the 2018 search engine ranking algorithms, dwell time matters, and this is going to increase. How long somebody spends on your page is going to be significant because it's a quality signal to Google that your page is valuable because people are spending time there. And keep in mind, don't think whole website is the same. You got to take things page by page by page by page. You can have a website that has multiple pages that rank well and others that don't do anything. So we look at each page individually. So the longer they spend on that page is going to help you on the search engine rankings. And so we want to do things like give them, you know, things to slide through, swiping through a photo gallery, watching videos, engaging with a tool that's on the website. These are things that can help your ranking. And so embedding video does that. It increases, it can increase engagement. And so as a indirect signal, it absolutely helps. In addition, if you look at all the SEO tools now, like my favorite, which is SEMrush, we're able now to look at SEO content suggestions, like in the SEMrush's SEO content template or their on-page SEO checker. One of the key components they're comparing now is competitor against competitor ranking on page one of Google, who's using video. Well, that would not be the case if it wasn't being looked at by the search engines. And so we're seeing this more and more that they're measuring for who's using video on their blog posts. So this is an important strategy that you can implement right away in your 2018 video and SEO efforts. Start to embed video on your blog posts and on your website and watch what happens. Learn more at ranklikeaboss.com.